We'll read the scriptures of God.
Josué chapitre 5 verset 1 à 2.
Joshua chapter 5 verse 1 to 2.
Si matutaki na verset 15.
And then we'll read verse 15.
Si matutaki Josué chapitre 6 verset 1 à 2.
And then we'll read Joshua chapter 6 verse 1 to 2.
Josué chapitre 5.
Joshua chapter 5.
Papa, c'est papa, un moment, Zali, on te laisse. Ah, Marie, bon, qui m'est Zali? Merci. Josué, chapitre 5.
Joshua, chapitre 5.
Verset 1 à 2.
Verset 1 to 2.
Josué, chapitre 5, verset 1 à 2. Je lis au nom de Jésus. Lorsque tous les rois de Amoréens chapitre 1, lorsque tous les rois des Amoréens à l'occident du Jourdain et tous les rois des Cananéens près de la mer apprirent que l'Éternel avait mis à sec les eaux du Jourdain devant les enfants d'Israël jusqu'à ce que nous ayons passé, ils perdirent courage et furent consternés à l'aspect des enfants d'Israël.
Akauki saki maina ya ladena mpona yisalare kino esiraki bango kukata ngambo mitema na bango minangwaki mpe molende etikaraki na bango lisusu tena tira na batona Israel.
So it was when all the kings of the Amorites who were on the west side of the Jordan and all the kings of the Canaanites who were by the sea heard that the Lord had dried up the waters of the Jordan from before the children of Israel until we had crossed over, that their hearts melted, there were no spirits in them any longer because of the children of Israel.
En ces temps-là, l'Éternel dit à Josué, fais-toi des couteaux de pierre et circoncis de nouveau les enfants d'Israël une seconde fois.
At that time the Lord said to Joshua, make flint knives for yourselves and circumcise the sons of Israel again the second time.
15. Et le chef de l'armée de l'Éternel dit à Josué, ôte tes souliers de tes pieds, car le lieu sur lequel tu te tiens est saint. Et Josué fit ainsi.
Mokonzi na basoda na Yahweh, alobela ki Joshua, longola mapapa na makolo na yo po ete sika ezali yo kotele mezali bule. Joshua asalaki bongo.
Then the commander of the Lord's army said to Joshua, take a sandal off your foot, for the place you where you stand now is holy. And Joshua did so.
Josué chapitre 6 verset 1.
Josué chapitre 6 verset 1 à 2, j'ai lu au nom de Jésus. 1. Jéricho était fermé et barricadé devant les enfants d'Israël. Personne ne sortait et personne n'entrait.
Jéricho est kangamaki na bikukena mpe ezipamaki na tina na bato na Israël.
Now Jericho was securely shut because of the children of Israel. None went out and none came in.
L'Éternel dit à Josué, vois, je livre entre tes mains Jéricho et son roi, ses veillants soldats.
Yahweh le voilà qui Joshua et Tala. La Syrie passe à Jéricho dans le roi qu'on a eu.
And the Lord said to Joshua, see, I have given you Jericho into your hand, its king and the mighty men of Valor. Let's pray.
Père de gloire,
Father of glory,
Dieu d'Abraham,
God of Abraham,
le Dieu tout-puissant,
God Almighty,
Zambé na bamboli kombo na yo.
Lord, I bless you.
Zwan kem.
Receive the
praise.
Receive the praise.
Tika moli mona ya kambaniso.
Let your spirit guide.
Moli mona ya pambola matuna.
May your spirit bless your people.
Tika etolo bila matuna yo Zambé.
May you speak to your people, Lord.
Na kanginguya ya Satan.
A captain Satanic spirit.
Bemi yango na yango.
And all its power.
Abo kiyamo na bisika
bika. I throw it into dry places.
Na kombo ya Yesu Kristo ya Nazareth.
Your name Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Zambé na bomo. Amen.
Mothers, fathers, and youths that have had the chance to be here with us this evening.
Dimanche passé,
last Sunday,
Olimamo Santo alobela kibiso ikolo na mwasi babenga kisara.
The Holy Spirit spoke to us about a woman called Sarah. The theme that we continue to speak of is called the just shall live by faith.
And
the Holy Spirit helped us to explain the way he could to bless those that were here last Sunday. Today, the Lord has sent
us
to speak upon the words that he said to Joshua. The Lord said to Joshua, look,
na pesi yo Jericho.
I have given you Jericho.
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 Na mokonzi na yango.
With its king.
Na basoda na bangonyo so na kabeli bino bango.
And with all their might and valor, I have given them.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Parole oyo.
These words.
Na miso boyezo mona nate.
Within your eyes, you cannot see.
Mayo simba yango ezate.
You're not able to hold it yet.
Me ozana devoir ya recevoir yango par la foi.
But you have the duty to receive it via faith.
Parce que Nzambe akosakati.
Because the Lord does not lie.
Me tambo tozako lobela Josué.
But when we are speaking of Joshua,
c'est-à-dire Moïse.
It means Moses had already passed away.
Moses,
he was no longer alive. And the Lord gave to them a city called Jericho. What exactly do we want to introduce, develop, and then conclude? The first thing. After a person believing in Jesus as their Lord and Savior, all sorts of things will occur within your life. From the day that you believe in God until the day that you will go to die, you have battles in which you need to report back its victory. Do you understand?
Because
faith does not go backwards.
No.
Faith.
It
only believes in victory within the life of the children of God. When you convert your heart, and you decide to give your life up to Jesus,
esengeloyo ba ete okokutana na ba difficulties.
You must know that there will be difficulties that will occur. Yes.
Il faut le voir.
You must know this.
Ebele.
A lot.
When
they believe in Jesus.
No, no.
No.
So kakutana na difficulty alo nimezambia zato azato.
As soon as a difficulty occurs, they're thinking, does God even exist?
Okokutana na ba difficulty.
Difficulties will occur.
Realité,
the reality is what?
So ki, otani verse 1.
If you read that verse,
Bible lobi ke Jericho ezalaki bloke Israel akokota te pe akobimate.
The Bible states that Jericho was now shut down. No one could go in and nobody could come out.
And not return.
In other words, they were not able to enter within the possession of that country.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Et depuis Israël,
at the defeat of Israel, it was that battle was that they needed to enter within Jericho. Their battle
was
that they needed to overtake Jericho. But how would they do that?
By the
faith. By faith.
Parce que Jericho,
because within Jericho,
basotabaza,
there were soldiers,
ruaza,
there was a king,
armeza,
there was an army,
bazana,
they had their own weapons. But where would they, how exactly could they
do it?
Within their minds, they
Jericho.
Weren't able to conquer Jericho.
Zambe alomina Jericho.
The Lord said to Jericho.
Alomina Josué.
Said to Joshua.
Alomina Pesi Oje.
Said, I've given to you Jericho.
Makambo nyonso yoyoko kutana na yango.
Everything that may occur ahead of you.
Zambe alomina yebisa yo ebangisa yo.
The Lord said, let me tell you that none shall fear.
Makambo mosusu ezako ya liboso
na. There are a lot of things that are about to happen.
Toko afronte ya.
We will have to go through.
Nimokoro moko te obanga.
But not one day should you be afraid. Not at all. Do not fear. Moreover, you have the duty to believe in He who has saved your life. When a person is removed from the hands of
Satan,
you need to know that Satan is not okay with
no.
It. No. The verse that we have read, it has three things. That's what we're about to develop.
Hallelujah.
I repeat the first thing. When you've moved away from the hands of God, how exactly have you
moved away from the hands of God?
From the day that you said to Jesus, I have now given to you my life. From that day, the dark world is not okay with
me.
The dark world is angry. And the anger of the dark world is not that they have the power to do anything upon you. The anger of Satan
is that because you are in danger for the world of
darkness. Because now you are a danger to their kingdom.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Another way you can
say, when a person believes in God,
and he comes back to ya ebale olongwena ere mususu komina ere mususu.
It means that you have now crossed over onto the other side of the river.
Okatisi ebale.
You have crossed over the sea.
Esengelo ebale.
Therefore you must know.
Is that present for?
This is very important.
Present for.
Very important within the land of the man.
Only
my yes. You believe in God. But yet your heart still fears. The reality is that you do not actually know what it means to believe in God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Do not sleep. Do not sleep. Do not sleep.
Do not sleep.
The things that will actually give you a blessing is what we are speaking.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The presence of all those that believe in them, the Lord has never gone to
say.
The dark world is never okay with.
You're
you're now a danger to
them.
Instead of them being a danger to you, you're now the danger to them. This is the truth that needs to be spoken. I want to open a bracket I'm about to read. But if you look today, today's evangelism, people are showing us that Satan is more dangerous.
No.
My Bible does not say this.
No.
You must read verse 5.
Chapter 5, verse 5.
Is that Satan?
Is that Satan?
Is that the witch? Very simple. If you're like a visitor within
someone's house,
you go to their house and you say, okay, I'm coming. See that hook? If there is a witch, they already know. They would already know that the person that has entered him cannot live. You don't know that there is a witch. But I'm telling you that the witch knows that the person that is
here.
They have brought in light that I am not to fly at night.
You
too. Who should be uncomfortable?
Yeah.
Who should actually be uncomfortable? You
know,
that you did not yet know that there was a witch inside the house. You get to the house. But within that house, there is a witch.
Hallelujah.
You know. Who within you must be uncomfortable? Don't say it as if it's not. Be very clear. The reality of the evangelism that you have been preaching. Who would be dangerous? How you and the witch you should be. They're not able to tell us that the one that we have, he is a God Almighty. Even if I know that that's the one. You see, this one is the way. A believer, you're not allowed to fear. Are you listening? Because your presence, it is fair for that witch that you must understand.
No,
a witch. They're not afraid of you. But what's scaring the witch upon your life?
It's
Jesus, the work that the Lord has done to free you from his hand. Yes, I get to go up to this. Let me open a bracket I'm about to open. Believers. As soon as they hear demons or witches, they can pray at least 100 times. Even 100 times. I'm asking myself. It's not because of our prayer. The Bible says what? My Bible says what? The Israelites started to them cross. The cross. And they got to the other side. And you know what happened to the Pharaoh's and his army? Is that
wrong?
Is that not right?
Is that wrong or not?
Is that not right? My Bible says what? My Bible states when the king of the city that was ahead of them, when those kings heard the things that the Lord had done for the Israelites when they were crossing the Jordan, they said their hearts melted. You know how
it is.
When some sort of oil
comes out,
just put water, fire on it, and it will melt. It will melt. The first thing, the second thing, my Bible states, their bodies were weak. Listen carefully. When they heard of the things that the Lord had done for the Israelites after they crossed the Jordan.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says what? The kings of the other city within the city of Jordan. The king of the Canaanites, they heard the word that the Lord had done for them when they crossed the sea. It's very important. Very important. Was the Israelites afraid? Were the Israelites the one who were afraid? He was afraid. Those kings with their arms, with their souls, because of the powerful hand of God upon their life.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I will be forced to make this right.
So their strength will weaken.
Oh, kokati sa mine in that kikoliba.
Whereas to cross the sea, what exactly did it mean?
It's like baptism.
It was baptism. That the Lord baptized the Israelites so that they could cross over to the other side. I want to say that. The baptism that Israelites
received,
what does that baptism
mean?
All those that believe in God as their Lord and Savior, their baptism, it means to die and to resurrect along with Christ.
Hallelujah.
I've been sent this eve to tell you from the day that you said, Jesus, I now believe in you. I believe in your name. I believe your death and resurrection. From that day, the king of Jordan and the king of the Canaanites, they were not afraid, not okay with it. Who was the king? Of those kings. Those kings. They represented Satan with his demons. As soon as the person believes in God, you have agreed to die and to resurrect them. He is uncomfortable upon your life. Are you listening?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If a believer, then do not know these things, your faith is unbalanced. Today you'll be fine. Today, tomorrow you'll be sick. It's simply because you don't have a position. You think that the things that are occurring to you see that those issues are much greater than what the Lord has done for you. The dark world is a friend.
It's
fearing you because of the death of Jesus upon your life. Do you understand? Even the house that you are sleeping, the devil must run
away.
But today, believers are the ones that run away.
They're
living the same house.
You
say, no, I must leave. You will see a believer run. They leave the witch a whole land to fly around. Where we are, no witch can fly.
No.
How would they even fly? How can they
fly?
Because Jesus said, we are the light of the world. All which they only work within the dark. And if light is where we are, there's nothing. Let me tell you. All those that have converted
to God,
all those that believe in God, once you enter a place, even if there was dark, you will see that there's dark. All the demons, Satan and the witch, you see that there is great light here. Someone has entered.
Hallelujah.
I've been sent to tell
you
the first thing. Know the job that the Lord has done for you. What is that job? To believe in Him. You've agreed to die
with
Him. You've resurrected along
with
Him. And the dark world is testifying upon the death of Christ upon your life. The demons testify. If they enter within their means, it's a problem. We go to Pastor Boyanga. I'm telling you that he prayed upon a mother that we entered
with.
The way we all scurried off, you will never believe. That person, they are very dangerous.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. When you believe in God, the first thing you need to know is the work that the Lord has done for you. That should be the foundation of your faith. Why is that? Because you can go through
problems.
You can go through problems. But if you do not know the value of the work that the Lord has done for you, your faith is nothing. If you do not know that the dark world, it fears you, it is afraid of you. Because of the word that the Lord shed His blood for you. If you don't know this, then you're here within your mind to just cry. It's just fearing. It's just asking. Whereas if you believe in God, you're no longer allowed to fear it. This is what I say to people. The stage of which is eating us is already
gone.
Is there somebody that believes this? How many people believe it? Who actually believes it?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Once you believe, all you have
It means you have accepted to die on resurrection. This means your flesh,
you have now
died along with Christ, and the life of Jesus has now entered within you. This is what Paul said. It is not I who is living, but rather it's Christ who is living within you. If God is living within you,
can I
eat
Jesus?
Do you ever eat Jesus?
3 days.
The land is so
warm.
He said, this one we cannot keep. Satan knows. Because Christ wept on the ground. He took the key back that Satan stole from Adam and Eve within his garden.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is that principle?
It's very important. The first thing. You must know the God that you believe in. Who is he? The Lord said to Joshua. He said, Joshua, you must conquer Jericho. I have given it to you. But for you to conquer Jericho, you must know these things. You must know these things. If you do not know it, you will never get to
Jericho.
You will never conquer Jericho. Never. In other ways, I want to say, we all have promises that the Lord has promised. We all have blessings that we must receive within
ourselves.
The Lord promised you great things. You had a
dream.
They prophesied. But there is a great prophecy which is within the book of Galatians. That all those that believe in Jesus as their Lord and Savior, they are the children of Abraham. They are the children of
Abraham.
We are inheritance to the promises that the Lord promised to Abraham. The Lord said to Joshua, I have given you Jericho. He has given it to you. But the reality is, when the Lord was speaking to Joshua, Joshua was outside.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When the Lord was speaking to Joshua was not inside. He was outside. The doors were all shut. Everything was shut. The word of the Lord was a promise.
Joshua.
But for Joshua to actually reach and enter with the first thing was that they needed to know that those kings are now fearing. They needed to know that those kings with their arms, they are all fearing them because of the God that they carry. That was the assurance. That's the assurance. That was a whole assurance. There was nothing that it needs you to know. The hunger fears you. You need to know
that
the poverty fears you. That you must know that sickness fears you. You must know
that
even sins itself. If you know this, the Lord has put you above it all. That's right. That's right. That's where there's a big
issue.
A believer, they have nothing to eat. Look at them.
Oh,
but you're scared of reading Hunger Spirit.
Jesus has signed a decree.
Jesus signed a decree. He said, "Do not worry about tomorrow." But tomorrow,
we'll
worry for you. In the life of a believer, there are battles. There are battles that we need to be victorious in because the enemy fears us due to the work of the cross.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Alleluia.
Amen.
The Lord is in need. After them crossing the sea, the Bible says three things to us. What
exactly?
For God to get to the point of telling Joshua that I've given you Jericho. This is what the Lord starts
with.
One day, the Lord said to Joshua, he said, make a flint. A flint. That
night,
you must circumcise all the sons of Israel. They're all the men. You must circumcise them all. You and I, we could not walk in the same
place.
You're looking for
Jericho.
They promised you Jericho. The Lord has already given you blessing. Jesus already went up the
door.
He said, all is now complete. That's the truth. The dark world knows that Jesus already finalized everything. Jesus to Joshua. He said, Joshua,
all the strong ones
that you were walking with, they've all died on the way because of their arrogance. The Lord removed them. The Bible says he killed them. Those the mighty ones. The Lord killed them all. Listen to
me.
You know why? Because they were not paying attention to the voice of the Lord. If you believe in God, if you know that your enemy thinks, the second thing, you must pay attention to the voice of the Lord. You must pay attention to the words of God. If you want to receive Jericho, you must be circumcised. Let me explain
circumcision.
Those that were circumcised is us. The pagans. Those that did not know God. The sinners. Those that lacked hope. And those that were circumcised were those the family of God called Israel. In other ways, I could say, all those that are a sinner, you're the ones that they call that you're uncircumcised. For you to become a believer, for you to become a child of God, you must be circumcised within your life. The Lord said to Joshua, he said, Joshua, you must be circumcised. In other words, the Lord wants to say, within you, I see the pain for you to enter into that. People must confess the
Lord in
their hearts. What does the Lord want to say? Listen to me. Jericho is ahead of
you.
Jericho is not far. Because my Bible says what? Is ahead of them is fearing. What does the Lord want to say? You want to receive Jericho? Then you must stop sin. Then you must be removed. I want to say it in a different way. If you want the promises that the Lord promised you to be accomplished, you must be circumcised. You must confess your sin. You must take the decision to stop. And then, that's when you have the hope to
enter.
You have a way of entering into the position. If you do not confess, or convert your heart, you're not allowed the promises of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let no one lie to you. Let nobody bring false evangelism. Prosperity. Just prosperity. Now go
ahead.
At the end of prosperity, they'll ask you. Those that are
sinners.
Well, how are you preaching to the
people?
The Lord is talking to
Joshua.
He said, Joshua, listen. Take your flip line. Take your flip line. People must convert their heart. You're not far from Jericho. But you cannot receive if you do not convert. Brothers and sisters, you can make your own flesh suffer. You can fast. You can pray. If you do not stop sinning, then your voice is nothing. It's nothing. The cure to receive Jericho is called believing and converting your heart in truth. That's it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You want to hold Jericho within your hand? What is Jericho? Jericho is a blessing that the Lord promised.
But no,
from the day you
were
born. What the Lord has promised you, you have not yet held. The King has told me to tell you. You will reach, you will hold, and you will see.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Vérité.
The truth.
Vérité.
The truth.
You
can come.
Toby.
We dance. We do everything. There's only one thing. The Lord wants the righteous one. God. He is in need of the righteous one. It was clear. They were close to Jericho.
He
should have left them
entered.
What was missing? But he could not give the glory to Satan. The glory of God belongs to
him.
The Lord is in need.
For you
to prepare yourself. To decide within your heart. Because you are the Joshua of your family. The Lord is in need. And to receive what the Lord has promised
so
you.
Once
you hear,
once
you decide within your heart, the word will speak upon your name. The word will testify upon you. The word will speak of you. And even when they will speak of you, they will forget that you came out of a world. The Lord is in need for you to be circumcised. Before you came to England, you had a
life.
You had a life. The reality is that you never actually broke up.
Voyage in
the
Kabul.
You come here in the UK. The Lord has given you with his love, with his mercy. Till today. You still have
one of
you need to confess and stop doing it.
Your siblings call
the in-law, where's the in-law? In your life, how many in-laws do you need to have? How many in-laws? If people are messing around with you when it comes to the work of God, I've been said to tell you the truth. It's either you take or you leave. God does not beg you. Neither does he force him to believe in you. The choice he has given it to him. Do you not cry? You come here. If you hear even an angel doesn't pray. Sit next to them.
They're
praying. They're connecting to the
Lord.
They're aware of the reality.
But whereas
the reality is, you do not want to stop. You must stop the power
of the
Lord. You're not lying to people. You're only lying to people. You're next to Jericho.
You will not receive.
Nani azonoko?
Who is suffering?
Is
it God?
No.
But it's you. Because you're in need of blessing.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jericho. Jericho.
Jericho.
The Lord said to Joshua, I have given to you Jericho. I have given to you Jericho. But you will not enter if the sinners do not stop sinning. Brothers and sisters, the Lord wants to speak to you this
morning.
You're crying because of your
business.
Your Jericho is a children. Your Jericho could be money that you're
living.
Your Jericho could be the hope that you're
living.
Your Jericho could be the marriage that you're living. You're looking for marriage that stop the life that you're living. You're here. The Lord is entrusting himself to you.
Do
you get married? You don't want to get married. But you just want to know how much money does that mama have? And I'll sit at. Can you take the table? Can you take the calculator?
Let's
start to calculate the amount of support and the total.
Jesus,
you will receive what the Lord has promised you. The cure is one.
was
the fuel?
It's a was that fuel? Let your faith know. The way I am
walked.
All the demons that are
inward
greet know that part. The Lord has already healed
it.
The same way the Lord healed it
for
his
God,
they shake, they fear, they do not sleep. I want to speak on the third point. We spoke of 2 points.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bana ya karasi yasi bozo kuma.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We're now on the third point.
Una
a question was asked yesterday.
Tango Josué.
God went Joshua.
Atelem.
Stood up.
Alobi akene kotala Jericho.
And he said, let me go and visit
a
my Bible states, Joshua lifted up his eye. Instead of him seeing Jericho, he saw one man with a sword at his hand. My Bible states, Joshua went to that man. He asked him, are you with us?
Or
are you at the side of the enemy? You must be a man. Because if it was an enemy, he would kill you straight away. With Joshua a friend. He asked him, are you with us? Or are you in the side of the enemy? Joshua tried to lift his eyes to see Jericho. He could not see. He did not see. The man told him, I am the leader of the army of the living God. When Joshua heard,
my
Bible says that Joshua fell to his
knees
and he began to pray. He said, Lord, what have you done to me for me to see such a man? Listen to the words of the leader of God. He said, Joshua, remove your shoes. That question was
on
yesterday. To read the Bible is good.
Others said we're
now confused. Let me tell you. In the life of the
Lord,
we have 2 parts. There's a period of time when the Lord will want you to remove your shoes. And there will be a period of time when the Lord will tell you to put on your shoes. If you cannot put your shoes back on if you have not yet taken it off. Let me develop in the things that we spoke about. Moses. They told him to remove his shoes. He had the blood of
people
because he killed him. That's what the Holy Spirit helped us speak of. But what's surprising? Joshua did not kill
him.
Joshua did not sin. So how can he be told to take off his shoes? Right. And that's where they are. A person he did not kill, he did not steal. He does not have the blood of
God.
But the words came.
He
said, Joshua, where you are now standing, it's a holy
place.
Remove your shoes. Remove your shoes. Joshua removed his shoes. And he fell down. He said, Father, what have you done? He's already bowing, kneeling down with his shoes already off. What does the Lord want to say? Listen to me, brothers. Listen. You cannot enter
Jericho.
You cannot receive Jericho. If you have not yet fixed your relationship with God, let me explain.
Joshua,
he needed to remove his shoes. Why? The shoes were represented what? He needed to remove his thoughts of the man. The thoughts of trying to calculate how will I enter Jericho? To remove those thoughts of thinking. They have locked up. They have captured it. The plan that they have with you. Wherever will we end? That person told
true.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Biblia.
The Bible.
Fokoyeba.
You must know.
Okokoma print.
You cannot be ready. You wear the shoes. It means that you're ready to go. But you cannot go. You can't go. If you have not yet fixed your relationship with
Joshua.
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 Joshua. For you to
enter.
For you to enter. You must put your heart to the Lord. As soon as Joshua removed his shoes, he fell to his
knees.
He looked for the face of the Lord. And the next thing
he
said, Joshua, I have given you Jericho. The Lord said those words after Joshua removed his shoes. Let me tell you who came to see
him.
You have the duty to fix your relationship with
God.
Remove your thoughts of
God.
Remove your intelligence. Remove your knowledge. Because there's no by your
strength.
There's no by your
strength.
It is because of the power of God. Listen to what the Lord is saying. Listen to what the Lord is saying. Listen to what the Lord is saying. Joshua was trying to look. The Lord said, you cannot see it. Go your knees. But for you to enter. Listen to what that man said. That man said what? Remove your shoes. Because the one that we have is God who is saved. He is a saint. You're here,
you're
here. Move away from being a youth. Stop taking God's things as a joke. Stop taking your relationship with God as a joke. Do you not see yourself as a joke? Relationship with God. I'm telling you. You will hold Jericho with your hands.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is speaking to you. The Lord is addressing himself to you. You've cried a lot. You've cried a lot. You're asking yourself, what should I do?
Family anger.
My family. Is it a curse? There's nothing to do with a curse. Take your life seriously. God does not joke around. God is God. He's safe. You believe in him? You have the duty to walk within him. Believe
in
him. You have the duty to attach yourself
onto him.
When Joshua fell, he cried. He removed his shoes. And the Lord said, now listen to what's
about.
He said, there's things they just need to
make a trumpet.
Seven trumpets. To go around. To go around. To go around that city. Nobody will speak.
Just
the seven trumpets. The seven trumpets. Because it's not by your power. It's not by your strength. This is why. All those that have the Holy Spirit.
Zambe azako sa Christina.
The Lord is addressing himself to you.
Ozalia mama.
You're here, mama.
Ozalia.
You want Jericho? Cry the Lord. Stop sinning. You want Jericho? The Lord wants you to believe
in
me that I, the witch is here because of the work of
God.
They know me. They fear me. They're scared. Their hearts are melted.
Satan.
Satan. The witch of the family, of all of the whole of the
street,
they lack, if you understand
this,
not one day will you glorify a witch within your mouth.
Let me not glorify
Jesus. Take your heart, give it to the Lord so that he can give you the secret which will allow you to receive your Jericho. To connect yourself. How will you connect yourself? If you stop sinning. If you have hope. If you believe. If you understand that Satan has
There's no one that will.
No guns will.
Yeah,
it's simply. So just do that and everything. Let this evening, Mom. May you take these things.
Your life is a blessing.
But you can slow yourself down if you do not listen to the words that the Lord is
saying.
Joshua, he received
because
he was the one that was guiding him. He was simply listening to what the Lord
said.
Once he received, that was it. Moses, they removed his shoes.
Joshua, same thing.
May you cry.